Hello everyone! In this video, I will be showing you a simple yet fascinating geometric method to plot all types of conics, parabolas, hyperbolas, and ellipses, all at once. But before that, first I need to show you two geometric constructions that generate families of straight lines. Here we're going to start with a straight line L, a point on the plane O, and a point P that moves along the line L. Then we draw the perpendicular bisector between P and O, that is the line bisecting the segment PO, if Q is the intersecting point of the perpendicular bisector and segment PO, then QO is equal to PQ. Now let's see what happens when we draw multiple perpendicular bisectors when P moves along the line L. As you can appreciate here, we obtain a family of straight lines. Not only that, all together seem to outline a curve, which probably you already recognize it. Yes, it's a parabola, and as long as the point is not on the line L, you will always get a parabola. With this construction, we just obtain a parabola defined as an envelope. An envelope is a plane curve that is tangent to each member of a family of planar curves. The points of tangency together form the whole envelope. In this case, each perpendicular bisector is tangent to this parabola. It is not difficult to prove that the envelope is in fact a parabola. We just need to remember its definition. A parabola is a plane curve generated by a point moving so that its distance from a fixed point, the focus, is equal to its distance from a fixed line, known as the directrix. To find this point, just draw the line passing through P perpendicular to L. Now let's begin with a circle with center O and a fixed radius, a point Q on the plane and a point P defined on the circle. We draw the perpendicular bisector between P and Q, that is, if R is the intersection of the segment PQ and the perpendicular bisector, then PR is equal to QR. Now let's see what happens when P moves around the circle and draw perpendicular bisectors for each position of P. As you can appreciate here, the family of straight lines outline now something resembling a hyperbola, and it is in fact a hyperbola as long as Q is outside the circle. But if Q is inside the circle, then the curve becomes an ellipse. When Q is outside the circle, it is easy to prove that the envelope is a hyperbola. We just need to recall its definition. A hyperbola is a planar curve generated by a point moving so that the difference of the distance from two fixed points, the foci, is a constant. In this particular case, the foci are O and Q. We just need to find the point that generates the hyperbola, which you can find by drawing the auxiliary line passing through the center O and the point P. When Q is inside the circle, again, it is easy to show that the envelope is an ellipse. An ellipse is a planar curve generated by a point moving in such a way that the sums of its distances from two fixed points, the foci, is a constant. Again, the foci are the points O and Q, and to find the point that generates the ellipse, draw the auxiliary line passing through the center O and the point P. Now, let's turn our focus back to the previous geometric construction. First, remove point P and observe what happens when point Q follows a specific path. Let's see that again, this time without the family of perpendicular bisectors. Notice that Q moves along a line segment, and this raises the question. Do the families of hyperbolas and ellipses form an envelope or envelopes? That is, curves that are tangent to each one of those hyperbolas and ellipses. Well, the answer is yes, of course. In fact, we obtained two envelopes, and they seem to be parabolas. Isn't that amazing? Have you seen this construction before? Let me know in the comments. The The two parabolas that we just obtained are the envelopes or families of hyperbolas and ellipses. And that's it, we just obtained all types of conics all at once. Here are a couple of challenges for you. First, try to prove that if Q is outside the circle, the resulting curve is a hyperbola, and if Q is inside the circle, the curve is an ellipse. Second, try to find the points that generate these two parabolas. Here's a hint, draw two auxiliary lines that are tangent to the circle and parallel to the straight line passing through its center and Q. I also encourage you to explore all the constructions using a dynamic geometric software. GeoGebra, in this case, is a fantastic tool for this, as it includes all the geometric tools that you will need to dynamically draw points, lines, circles, and more. But if you prefer, maybe I can show you the GeoGebra construction in a future video. Let me know in the comments below. And that's it. Thanks for watching, and thank you to all my patrons. If you would like to support this channel, check the links in the description below. Have fun exploring all types of conics as envelopes of plane curves. Bye-bye.